So the next meta heuristic that we want to discuss is called simulated annealing. It introduces a kind of randomness into the method for searching a good solution. So it is pertains to the meta heuristic techniques, and it due to this randomness that it implements, it is capable of escaping local maxima. It focuses on finding the tallest hill in our solution space. So maybe you are unfamiliar with what I'm talking about, and I have prepared a little example for you to understand local search methods. So let's assume that we have Kevin, who was on a boat that has sunk, and he arrived on an island where now he wants to establish where he finds himself. So he wants to go up a hill to have an overlook on his island and where he finds himself. So he's caught in a jungle where he cannot see so far. And that means he has to find his way through the jungle to find a higher point on where he is currently. Just to make you understand how this local search works, we assume that he can just walk in four directions, north, south, east, and west, and only one step at a time. So in each step that he has taken, he evaluates again where he needs to go further and where to go. So he is starting at F3. Well, that is this point here. So he's on the very bottom of his island. By the way, that is his island and that is Kevin. So these are now the steps where he, the island with respect to the altitudes. So he finds himself here at F3, and now he needs to evaluate where to go. So he evaluates each step. These are then his neighboring moves where he can go. Just for easiness, I copy and paste it here. So he has to evaluate now where to go. He cannot go to 15 because that would be across. He can just go north, east, south, and west. So the evaluation where he needs to go is fairly easy. We evaluate that. We take the objective value or those steps that leads to that is maximal. In this case, we evaluate this is zero, or this is he cannot go there. There is water, so he can go to 5 or to 14, and that means that his next step is to go to 14. So at this stage, then he looks again where to go next, and he evaluates again where to go. So he can go to 15. To 0, well, this is where we came from, or he came from, to 17 and to 10. So this is straightforward. He follows to go to east. And once again, he evaluates where to go. Now he's on 17. He can go to 19, 20, 21, or 14. So 14 is where he came from, and he selects the highest value. So he goes south to 21. So his next step is going to 21. And this goes on. We are now at the fourth iteration. He's at 21. He now established where to go next, and the highest value is 26, so he decides to go south again. And from 26 now, evaluating where to go, he came from 21, so the highest value in the neighborhood is to go south again to 31. And yeah, now at 31, he looks around again, and he realizes that all the neighbors where he can go are worse than where he came from. So we have, he's at 31, he can have 24 next, or 18, or 25, he came from 26. So he has actually reached the highest point from where he came from so far. But, well, this is how the local search works. But you can see in the island, or on the overview of the island, that there are tallest hills. So the tallest hill is 49, there's a smaller one, 48. So it would be desirable from where he is to just go to the highest hill. But as he doesn't have the overview of his island and he cannot see so far, he goes at a certain stage south. And that makes sense for his local search. But if he would have gone east again to 20 despite 21, then he would have reached very immediately the tallest hill of his island. But with this local search method, he cannot reach it. So we have an overview now. We see his island, and we know if Kevin just goes east all the time, then he will reach, after four steps, the tallest hill. But the local search method makes him go around, and now he's caught in his local optimum. So we need to have some methods when we apply heuristics that can accept in the method that we can worsen the objective value of a current trial solution and go and search for the solution space in order to find a better solution of what we have found so far. Here, Kevin is now all alone searching for his island, for the tallest hill. We have different heuristics and also meta-heuristics available that give more possibilities to search for the solution space. So, for instance, here we find an overview of meta-heuristics that include local search, and we have strategies including one solution, meaning that we are starting with one trial solution, and then we are applying a local search method to search the solution space to find a better solution than where we are. We have now we are dealing with simulated annealing. We have seen already how taboo search is doing the job, and there are different other meta-heuristics as well. We will also talk about strategies that include several solutions or a population of solutions. That are evolutionary algorithms, for example. So you can imagine now Kevin starts here, but if you have a population of trial solutions, then you could also have one shipwrecked person searching from that point, one from this point, randomly, so maybe another one that starts on a very high trial solution. This is random, so you can a good starting method is to find some way how to define well the population so that the search method will easily find better solutions. So shortly we talk also about how to implement evolutionary algorithms, and there are then different strategies as well available. So here, for instance, evolutionary strategies, one is implemented in the Excel solver. You can have genetic algorithms as well, and so forth. How does a meta-heuristic work? Now, a meta-heuristic gives a structure for heuristics to be applied. and the structure is normally the same. So we develop a model for our problem. For instance, we're looking at the traveling salesman problem. We find or define an opening method, how to compute an initial solution. So for instance, randomly choosing where in the solution space our Kevin would start his search. Doesn't need to be at the very bottom of altitude in the jungle. And that can also already spare a lot of waiting time. So it can be a random selection of an initial solution or a different method. Then we compute the objective function for the objective value of that solution. So for instance, we want to minimize the distance for the traveling salesman person. And he should visit the cities just once and returning back home. That is our objective. Then we need to define a function that transforms the solution to get a new one. In the taboo search, we have defined moves. When we have done the move, then we have put it in the taboo list, so we would not cycle back to this very move that we have just done, or also some in the past, depending how we define the taboo list. And in the simulated annealing approach, here I will demonstrate that we use the subtool routine that is also given in the Healy and Liebermann book. So we select randomly a number where to define the start and the end of a sequence to be swapped, and we randomly select it, but I will show you later on how that works. Then we need to define criteria for accepting or rejecting the new solution. In taboo search, we selected this neighbor that had the best objective value. In the simulated annealing, we will also select the neighbor with the best objective value. But if we worsen in our new trial solution, then we will define an acceptance probability so that we can actually escape from a local optimum where we would find ourselves in. So we accept worsening the objective value so that we might find a better solution. So if we start here and we cycle then to the local optimum here, we could accept now with simulated annealing to go to 25 and then to 24 or 23. Then we can escape this local optimum to accept a worse objective value in order to find a taller hill. This method can go on and on and on. So we need also to tell our method or algorithm when to stop. So we need to define a criterion when we want to stop this. So for instance, we could define that after 5 or 10 iterations where the objective value has not improved, we want to stop the method, and then we select the best solution that we have found so far. The application now of a simulated annealing approach, let's reconsider the example of the traveling salesman problem of the Helier and Liebermann book. You will see this is our example here, and here we have our matrix given with the distances. We have defined that one is our hometown, so here you see the index of the slots. And we have 7 cities, so we are starting with the initial triangle solution that is quite straightforward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then back to the hometown. And here we calculate with the index function of Excel the distances between that, and we find that for this initial trial solution, we have an objective value of 69. So we have to define several things. Let's shortly go back to our slides. I will go... Let's go through this shortly. We want to find the tallest hill, we take random steps in some directions where we apply a local search to search the solution space. We want to gradually move upward in our objective value, or the hill, if we take the example of Kevin on his island. And we want to more and more reject moves that would go in a downward direction, so that would worsen our objective value. We need to define a move selection rule, as we have done for Kevin, to move one step south, east, west, or north, and then select somehow the next candidate, and define an acceptance rule or probability that accepts the move to worse, and by how much. So, for instance, we can define the probability acceptance exponential from x, where x is defined as the current trial candidate here minus the starting solution divided by the temperature. So this is the case if we want to have, or if we have a maximization problem. If we have a minimization problem, then these two needs to be flipped. So we look first at where we came from, and then subtract the new candidate minus some temperature degree. And now the temperature is quite important. We need to define a so-called temperature schedule that we want to apply that then calculates the acceptance probability. So from the start, we want to have a large temperature that then continuously cools down our steel, so that we accept less and less to worsen our objective value. And that is that, first of all, when we want to search the solution space, we accept candidates that can really worsen our current solution. And then we accept less and less this. So this is also why it's called simulated annealing. It is we anneal steel, so we heat up steel. And so it has a high temperature, so we can form our steel very flexibly in the beginning when the temperature is high. And then when the temperature decreases, the steel becomes more and more stiff again. So this is the allegory that the simulated annealing is using. This is what I just said. So the procedure, as we have seen also with respect to the other meta-heuristics, the initial is that we start with some feasible trial solution, as we have seen also in the Excel, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and back to 1. We define the move, so the move selection rule, how to get to a new trial solution to be evaluated, and then we check this next trial solution if we want to accept it based on our current temperature schedule. And then we define for the next one, and we stop this algorithm when either the smallest temperature value has been reached, or we have for a certain number of iterations not an improvement of our objective value, and then we would stop the algorithm. So these are the questions that we need to answer when we set up an simulated annealing: how we want to select the initial trial solution, so where to drop Kevin on his island to search for the highest hill, how would we define the neighborhood structure, and how can Kevin move on his island. So here we had for our Kevin the local search method that he can just go in four directions. and we need to define our temperature schedule as well. So here, that is now the example. For that purpose, I switch to Excel again. And you will find the same numbers there. So here we have, as said, our initial trial solution, and we start with 69. And here we have our temperature schedule that is predefined, that is specific to the problem at hand. So we define for the first temperature schedule, and we want to apply it for our first five iterations. We define that the first temperature step is 0.2 multiplied by the initial or by the current trial solution, and that then becomes 13.8. So now we want to apply this to the first five iterations. So I want to demonstrate the first three iterations to you. Yeah, we have given for, or we defined that for our local search, we want to randomly select the starting slot and the ending slot of the sequence that we want to reverse. So we would, yeah, we can look at defining the probability, or we could automate this. Now I abstract a little bit from it because I don't want to make it too complicating in Excel. Excel is just a method that I show you how this works. It's just a presentation form because it's very time consuming to automate things, to apply actually the method heuristic in Excel. You will see that this is quite difficult if you just use formula. I would recommend, if you would want to automate a simulated annealing approach in Excel, that you use Visual Basic to get the steps going. But this requires programming, and this takes us too far. So here I just demonstrate it to you how it works. So this is our initial trial solution with 69 as the objective. And now we want, in our first iteration, to start the subtool selection and to select the first slot. So we could define a random number, and this one would let us start at the reversal at 2. At slot 2, because the home time we don't change, and back home we don't change that. Let's assume that this method, our random number, was selected slot 3 to be changed. And that the subtool selection, the random number that we select for our ending slot, has been slot 4. That would mean that for our initial trial solution, we would reverse 3 and 4 at that stage. And this is random. So we just randomly select a new subtool to find a new candidate. So it's absolutely random. When we flip now city 4 and 3, this actually works with our graphic. We have a new trial solution that is from 1 to city 2, 4, 3, 5, 6, 7, and back home. And this gives us a new distance of 65. And well, I blended that out. But 65 is actually better than our initial trial solution objective value. So we would accept to go to the goal there and to work with the next trial solution. Here I blend in already iteration 2. So here we have accepted this candidate, and now we would flip a coin once again to find the next slots for the reversal, for the subtool reversal. Let's assume that our random number hit the interval of slot 4, and that for the ending slot our random number has selected the slot 6. So we would now reverse this sequence. So here you can see our sequence was 3, 5, 6, and now we would reverse it to 6, 5, 3. This you can see here. And it's actually also feasible if we go from 1 to 2, then to 4, to 6, to 5, and back to 3. That is actually a feasible route that we can go. And we would have an objective value, a new one of 64. So this one is accepted as well because it is smaller than the one where we came from. And here I want to draw your attention now to the acceptance probability that is defined by the exponent of x. You find the formula also here. So we define our x as the subtraction of the previous trial solution minus the one that we have just found, divided by the temperature of the iteration where we find ourselves in. And there we see that for this candidate, we have an acceptance probability of 1. So we just accept that one. Then we go to the next trial solution. And let's assume that our random number has pointed us to reverse slot 6 now and slot 7. So we would now flip 3 and 7 to this. And when we look at our graph, we see that this is a feasible candidate. So we move from 1 to 2 to 4 to 6 to 5 and then to 7 and then to 3 and from 3 back home. So this is possible, but this candidate has a higher objective value than the one we came from. So the acceptance probability of accepting this candidate has dropped, as you can see, to 0.87. So the question is now if we want to accept this candidate or we want to reject a candidate and search for a new one and accept that one. As you can see in Excel, the demonstration, I hope, was quite clear. But of course, it is easier to program this algorithm in a different programming language. Another thing I want to draw your attention to is the Interactive Operations Research tutorial. It is a software piece that you can find on the webpage of our textbook. And I want to demonstrate now in a faster manner how the simulated annealing approach works. So here we have the same trial solution given as we started with. We have the distance of 69 given here. And here we have stated the acceptance probability and then if we would accept the candidate. So let's go to the next one. Here you find the temperature 13.8. And here you see that the first move that the algorithm does is to flip 3, 4, 6. It flips 5 and 6 to 6 and 5. And it reaches a better distance of 66, and the acceptance probability is 1, and it accepts this new candidate. Next iteration, we find a new trial solution, and this is by random choice. So every time that you would run this simulation or this tutorial, because of the implemented randomness, it would select a new trial solution. So here we see that what has been flipped was 6 and 5 again. So actually we go back to our initial trial solution with this. So we have a distance of 69 and the acceptance probability is now down to 80%. but we accept this new candidate. This goes on and on and on until, yeah, we can go on for quite a while. And here I want to draw your attention now to once is the temperature schedule. So you will see we started at 13.8 and then for the first five iterations, and then we go down with the temperature to 6.9 for the next iterations, and then the temperature decreases more and more and more for the trial solutions. So here actually, and here you can also see if we accept or reject the candidate and if we try to find a new one. And here you can see that this at iteration 16, we find a distance of 63. And but the algorithm would go on and search further and further until our stopping rule hits, and then we here we see that our best candidate is highlighted. So it's 63 with this route. So this example we find also once again in our lecture slides, but. I want to draw your attention to a very nice simulation of the algorithm with respect to a traveling salesman. So here you will find a list of routes or routes, the distance in the simulation, the algorithm that has been selected, this is simulated annealing, and the temperature. So, yeah, let's see how that works. Here you can see that a trial solution has been established, and now we see the simulation of the different moves with respect to the distances. So it might be a subtle reversal that is also applied here. And this is the simulation of the different of the trial solutions that have been found, and we see here also that the temperature decreases and decreases until a good candidate has been found. And here you see also that different other trial solutions are still accepted as the temperature has not yet reached the smallest value that is acceptable. So you see that the algorithm is still searching for better solutions and exploring the solution space.